Greetings, adventurers. Don here. Welcome back for another little tutorial for RPG Maker VxAce. And in this little tutorial, I thought I would touch upon how you might be able to use regions in a project to check if the player's walking on or touches a certain region, then you can have it to perform the next actions or commands accordingly to how you want. So you can see here I made a new map for the demo, and I have four regions already set up. Region one will be the lawn, and region two is the walkway, region three is the flower bed, and region four is a little pool. This is Old Man Withers' house. And what will happen each time the player steps on a different region, then I have it set so the old man will come out the door and yell at the player and say something. It's a kind of a comical little scene. But let's see how I check for that. I go to the events. In the upper left corner, I have the event that's going to check to see if the player is standing on a certain region, and if so, to do the next command, which is to turn on a switch. So this event is running in a parallel process. So basically, it is when the player is on this map with the parallel processing event running, it will run in the background at the same time that the other things are happening at the same time. So the player is still allowed to walk around on the map, and other things are allowed to occur at the same time. Now, you wouldn't want to have too many events with parallel processes running at the same time and on the same map, because it can cause a slowdown in the game performance. So try to use them sparingly. And also, I put a brief wait command at the top of the commands and the event page. And that means that instead of running like every cycle, it will wait a couple frames. So it gives the game a little breather, and it will won't be so bad on the performance hit that it could potentially cause. So so I just have a few comments I set up. Now, you don't need the comments, but I just put them there for reference. So if player is on region one, turn on the lawn switch, which will run the door event scene accordingly. Okay, so the player steps on the lawn, which is region number one. And how do I check for that? Let's look at this conditional branch here. And on tab four, right at the bottom, you can see a script option, and there's a little script call $game_player.region_id:==1. Now, what does that mean? Basically means the game will check if the player is standing on region ID number one, and if it's true, if it equals that, then it will do the next command, which in this case is to turn on the lawn switch, number 0001. If you look at, I don't have too many switches in this demo yet, but in this, I have four switches to check this map: the lawn, the walkway, flowers, and pool. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, so I'll just cancel out of that. And the same, it will check if the player stands on region 2. If so, turn on switch 2. If the player is standing on region 3, if yes, then turn on switch 3. And then finally, if the player is standing on region 4, then to turn on switch 4. And that's it for this little event. So let's say the player does stand on region 1, which is the lawn on my map. Well, what happens next? I have another event set where the doorway is. We'll open that up. And you can see I have several pages on this event. Now, page 1 just basically no switches are on, and it just basically shows the graphic of the closed door. Now, page 2 or tab 2, the condition checks to see if switch number 1 is on. And if so, then it's going to run a series of commands that I have set up over here. And some of the commands I have, it plays a sound effect of the door opening. Then I have a set move root command, which will show the little brief animation of the door opening. And then also to show old man Withers coming to the door. And I have the old guy yell at the character, tell him to get off the lawn. And the character responds saying sorry. And then have the player walk away a couple steps. And then I have the door close. Play a sound effect of the door closing. And at the very bottom, I turn switch 1 off. So now switch 1 is off. It will go back to the very first event page, which is basically nothing. It just shows the closed door. And the same idea for the rest. This checks to see if switch 2 is on, then to run these commands. The next one, if switch 3 is on, to run these commands. And the next one, if switch 4 is on, to run these commands. So they're all basically the same idea. But you could set it up to do something different as you like. So, for example, if I went to the region, if I had a region 5 here, and I could have it check if the player's on region 5, then to maybe transfer them to the next map, which I don't have in place yet. But that's one potential way you could do it without needing to use extra events. You could just check if the player is standing on that region. So I'm going to remove region 5 there because I don't need it for this. So now let's just briefly play the demo, and you can have an idea to see it all in action. So make any saves to your project, and let's play. Now I'll just move it up here so you can see the map, and then you can see the example in the game. Now I have it set up, so now when you walk down, I will be transferred to the new map I have set up. And let's say I have a sign that you can interact with. Welcome to Old Man Withers' residence. Stay off of my lawn, out of my flowers, and don't be putting your dirty feet in my pool. Oh yeah, no darn peddlers, this means you. This is Old Man Withers' place. That's quite the list of rules on that sign. I wonder if that old grouch would mind if I stepped onto his property. So, now if I stepped on the lawn or the walkway or the flowers or the pool, the different commands will happen accordingly that I put in. So let's say I'll step on his walkway, and the door opens, and you can see the old guy comes out to the door. Hey, can't you read? Well, I heard, yes, I, but, then go read my sign, and note the part that says, no darn peddlers allowed. That means you! Now get! But I was, I mean, I'm not, okay, okay, chillax, man, sorry, dude.
A bunch of my people is bothering me.
Okay, so, sorry about my cheesy voice acting there. But the same idea when you walk onto the different regions, I have it set so something different will happen. So you can check out the demo yourself. I will put a link in the description. And you can download it yourself and open it in your VxAce program and check it out. And maybe you can use a similar idea in your own project. And it's sort of a convenient way to check if the player walks on certain regions. So that's about it for this little demo. I hope you like it. And we will say farewell for now. Bye-bye.